With so many causes that you want to support in the news right now, you might be thinking to yourself, well, how do I support all of those and still save and build wealth? That's what we're going to be discussing today. Hi, I'm Joseph.
And I'm Tasha with One Big Happy Life, and we help you find balance, build wealth, and live happy. Everything that you need to create the life that you want.
With everything that's been in the news recently, a lot of people are really energized and want to do more good. And so we wanted to talk about, you know, balancing wanting to do everything with still being able to keep your finances in check and also build wealth. And so how do we do both of those things really well at the same time?
So first of all, we should all acknowledge that we are each called to serve the causes that we believe in differently, and that is okay. So there are going to be some people who are called to donate a whole bucket full of money, right? And there are some of us that would love to donate, say, a whole bucket full of money, but don't have a whole bucket full of money. And so it's okay to say, given who I am, where I am in life, and what I want from my own life, how can I best bring up, like, get together the resources to help support the causes that I believe in that are in alignment with me, who I am, and the life that I have?
Yeah, so just take a look at those resources that you have right now, be it free time, different skill sets, and then you can put whatever you can muster together right now to good use right now, and then we can always plan for different things later on.
Which we'll talk more about, but just making it clear that it's okay to either be the person that donates time, that donates skills, that donates $5, or that donates $100,000, because we each are living different lives and are in a different position, right? So just accepting that that is okay. And of course, the very first and easiest thing, especially with the movements that are happening right now, that we can all do is make sure that we vote and that we are active in our state and local governments and federal governments, understanding exactly what is going on, holding our elected officials accountable and letting them know that we absolutely will vote them out of office if they're doing some craziness.
While the federal government might get the most press across the nation, kind of makes sense. There are really more elected officials at the state and local level by far. And so in terms of sheer numbers, those elections are far more important than the federal elections, because we're only talking about a handful of people that are representing you at the federal level. Local level, that really, really impacts. So even if it's not a presidential year, get out there.
And understanding that different governments are responsible for different things. So the federal government doesn't have as much control over, say, what your state police are doing, what your local police are doing, what's going on in your schools, your real estate taxes. Like, the federal government doesn't have direct control over any of those things. That's why it's not enough to just focus on the presidential election on the federal level. You've got to go deeper and closer to home. So making sure, and that doesn't cost anything but time and just being committed to being aware of what's going on in the community around you.
Now that you've given a little bit of thought about actions that you can take and what resources you have, you're still not going to be able to do everything in the world. You're not going to be able to support every cause that exists. And so you're going to need to narrow it down, prioritize to the things that really matter to you most. And then, you know, make sure that you do what you can in those areas first. And so, you know, when you then run out of resources eventually, you know, your lesser priority missions that you want to support, those are the ones that end up getting cut. But then you can, you know, really lean into the things that you care about.
And we've kind of touched on this earlier, but spend some time thinking about where your time and resources are best spent. Because, like we said earlier, we're each called to serve in different ways, and we each have different financial capabilities and also skill sets that we can put towards furthering a cause. And so while Joseph and I could You know, there are many different ways that we could serve a cause. At the end of the day, we do have a couple of unique skills that not everyone has. And so maybe, like the fact that we are lawyers, maybe it's a good idea for us to look into ways that our legal skills can benefit the movement, because not everyone is able to contribute legal skills. Just about anyone can contribute some amount of time and some amount of money, but not everyone is a lawyer. In the same way, not everyone is a doctor or a nurse or a teacher, or not everyone knows about the way local governments work as well as someone that might have, that might be involved in local government and so might be able to educate the population about how best to be effective. So think about the specific skills that you have and look for unique ways that you can have the most impact on your causes. Just thinking beyond money, right? Because of course we can say, and we're going to talk more about the money side of things, but it does not just have to be money.
Now remember, even if you don't have a lot of money, small donations do add up. So if you've only got $5 to donate to a charity, but a million people feel the urge to donate those $5, well then that charity has $5 million. So while it might seem like a drop in the bucket, it really isn't, because a lot of drops will fill a bucket just the same as, you know, one big donation. So it really doesn't matter how much money you have, as long as, you know, you're energized and everybody else is like, okay, yeah, $5 will make a difference. Now, if you're new to donating money generally to charities, it's important to take a look at how efficient those charities are at doling out those that money to other charities, or actually boots on the ground doing the work. And every charity will be reviewed by a number of other charities. Other nonprofits. That they're, yeah. That what they do is they take a look at the reports and they say, okay, well, they took in this much money and 80% of it went to doing the work of that charity. So that's a good amount. And so you want to see how much administrative kind of spending they have. And, you know, the less that they have, the better.
Yeah, because the whole goal is to be as effective as possible in furthering the causes that you believe in. So while you should definitely start, no matter what, start small, even if it's a dollar. I find that a lot of places you can even donate a dollar and then cover the transaction fee. So it might end up being like an additional dollar after that, but that can make a huge difference. But even if you're starting small, if that doesn't feel like enough to you, set financial goals that align with your social justice goals. So in the same way where we say that you should set a goal to hit your minimum savings rate as soon as possible so you know that you're on track to reaching financial independence, set a goal to donate a certain amount, either donate a certain amount of dollars or donate a certain amount of time, and give yourself time to work towards that. Because once you set the goal, then it's in front of you as a guidepost so that everything that you're doing in your life is like, okay, am I getting closer to this or am I getting further away from this? Like when I quit my job last year, part of it was to grow One Big Happy Life so that I could make a bigger financial impact on the causes that I believe in. One of them being, and there are several, but one is that I want to be able to build a schoolhouse in Africa. And there's a particular organization that I've already identified that I want to work with. And that's really important to me. Am I there yet? No. But it is something that I have set as a goal that I want to be able to reach within my business.
Now, we've been talking a lot about how you can take action and also donating money, but let's not forget about the flip side, growing your own wealth. And so what can you do on the investment side? Well, fortunately, there are a number of different funds that take social justice issues into account and ethical investing. And so you don't have to just invest in everything. While we talk about investing broadly, it's still important, but there are funds that do their best to invest broadly while not investing in certain sectors of the stock market, bond market, whatever you're investing in. And so all it takes is identifying what's important to you and then which ethical investing or social justice investing funds you want to support, and then you can invest in those. And of course, if you need an advisor to help you with that, definitely seek them out. There are some investing apps. I know Wealthsimple actually has
they do yeah
has a, has a, two different options to, for for ethical investing. And so that is something that is out there. So don't think that you can't be supporting, you know, the for-profit companies in the same way with your investment dollars. You can still be doing it.
And there are lots of companies that are all about social entrepreneurship. So they're for-profit, but they want to make sure that they are both for-profit and also benefiting the world. So you can look into spending your dollars, not just investing, but also spending your dollars at companies that have those ethical solutions. Also, because both of these things will likely end up costing you more money. So you may not get the same return from these ethical investments. You may pay more for ethical products, and that's because those companies aren't cutting corners. So their costs are higher, so their returns are lower. So when you're choosing to invest in them, you're supporting that company, and you're also paying more for it. So it's almost like donating, because you are paying more than you have to by choosing to shop at a company that prioritizes the things that matter to you. So an example of that would be shopping at Costco, which is a company that there's lots of upward mobility. They pay their people benefits. And so do things cost more there? Sometimes. They can actually be cheaper sometimes, but we like that Costco treats their people well, and so we choose to shop there over much cheaper places because we would rather pay more to make sure that other people are also be able to live a good and happy life.
All right, so I hope that everybody has a better understanding of how they can continue to build wealth while supporting social justice and ethical things that are important to them. Let us know down in the comments what's important to you and how you're taking action.
All right, we'll see you guys in the next video. Bye.